Yo, how's it going, everybody? My name is JC Gaming, and welcome to a Death Frontier 2 review from an 11-year-old veteran, alright? So without further ado, let's just get right into it.
I ain't here for the money, though I'm about to make a change. Freedom for the ones who never gotta say, yeah, I did it all for you, and you can see it's coming true. On the pursuit, rocking the same shoes every second in session.
So yeah, guys, this review is going to be more or less neutral, alright? Neutral. Because Death Frontier 2 isn't really all the way updated. I don't know if that makes sense. I don't know if you guys agree with that. But basically, being an old veteran, I know for a fact that Admin likes to take his time with his games. You know, Death Frontier 2D, when I first joined, it was more or less completed. You know, he got out all the weapons, the new areas, the outposts. You know, there were the outposts with the, how do you call it, with the defending the outposts up in the roof, defending it from the front. That was really fun. I don't know why. But Death Frontier 2D had kind of a different style to all the other Death Frontier franchises that we have, but that we do now have. Death Frontier 3D is also more or less the same, you know? Again, it is where it is. People won't play that game anymore because it's a pay to win. People figured it out early in the game. But I mean, it's basically complete, and it's not a bad game, honestly. It's more or less fast paced. There are a lot of things to do. There's loots. There's a lot of variations, I guess. And yeah, but it's not to say it's. You know, the same about Death Frontier 2. Death Frontier 2 is in a position where I can call it a trash game. Again, the reason why I'm saying this is because I'm gonna leave Death Frontier 2 for a while. You know, I'm just gonna not play it. I'm not saying I'm quitting it, but I'm gonna leave it for a very long time. You know, maybe like 6 7 months, and I'm gonna come back and see what's going on, which is why I really can't wait for the future. But before I leave, I want to say what I feel about the game and what I just said about it being trash. It's true as of now. Because you know, you can't really say anything about it because it's an early alpha. But I mean, that's no excuse for a game of this caliber, Admin Poen. You know, when you release a game like this, you know, you're taking a gamble, all right? You're wasting your time and energy on a huge project that you've been working on for so long that you wanted to succeed. You can't half-ass everything, Admin Poen, all right? Death Frontier 2D was more or less of a success because it was much more simpler, I can say, but it had something going on for you know. It was more fun. It was not too crazy with the updates. It was not a huge pay to win. I mean, yeah, when the Gal 19 came out, it changed the whole style of the game. But the worst thing you could do is that you brought that pay to win concept to Death Frontier 3D. I feel that if you didn't bring that concept to Death Frontier 3D, you will have two Death Frontiers alive, honestly. You would have two games that will more or less be succeeding as of now. But hey, we're talking about Death Frontier 2. So, when you first log into the game, you're thrown into a huge survival world, all right? You basically have a free skill point, you know, you put it in there, blah, 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 and then you go to the police department. People have said that this game has a huge resemblance to Resident Evil 2 or the Resident Evil franchise, which I do agree it does. And we were all more or less excited that, you know, that there's an open multiplayer game for Resident Evil, but as we venture into the whole streets of the inner city, we realize that this is not the case, all right? You enter the police department, you find missions, you know, you gotta do what you gotta do, and you get on your way. After that, that's it. There's no story, there's no background, there's no other crazy side quests. That's it, you know? Me and most of my other peers that were in this Discord that is now pretty much dead because I'm not touching that frontier for a long time, we were all thinking, hey, what if he does bring back the Wraith, but it's gonna be in a crazy area where you need to basically do a raid with 8 or 10 other people, you know? Because it's, you know, if you try to keep it realistic, a Wraith, if it hits you once, you're pretty much dead. My guess. I mean, that thing is like, what, 50 feet tall? But yeah, you get my drifts. Things like those kind of concepts, Admin, you know? Or maybe the world is humongous. You know, that you can make your own house, barricade, you know, bring over like your own clan, you know, something that, you know, that you could do so much with this game. I mean, for now, you did stupid updates like the scrubland. I bet it took you a while, I mean, and I do respect that. But when I first entered the scrubland, it looked amazing. I was like, man, this looks like a great area for the end zone. No buildings, barely any light, just the moonlight shining on you. Why not make this the end zone? But no, you decided to make a PvP where barely 400, 300 players are playing it a day. You know, who's gonna PvP? I mean, come on. And then you do the whole thing, which I quote, you did fix, all right? You updated the game with a prestige 10 and a level 30 cap now? Like, I mean, come on, have we not learned from Deathloop to 3D where people don't want to grind all the goddamn day, you know? You know, this game, it's only, you're basically aiming it to an audience where, like, you know, it's just for people who don't have lives, honestly. You know, I only got you level 19 or, I don't even know, 15, and I'm like, nah, like, this is too boring, honestly. Like, every level that you go up is another 2,000 experience. You know, there's not really any concept to it. Just like, yeah, level 20, all right, you need another 2,000. Oh, level 21, another 2,000, you know, and it's like, it's just boring, you know, and there's nothing else that can help you, you know, find, that helps you capture, you know, that helps you capture the moment, you know. It's just, you go into a building, you go to 50,000 rooms, and you just loot and try to survive, you know, that's basically it. I mean, it got to the point where I could just find ammo, and I make like $1,000 off a box of ammo, you know, like, specifically 7.62, I mean, that's it, that was the game, you know. I'm like, wow, I found the easiest money-making guide here, just loot the ammo, and that's it, you know. If you want to level up faster, just kill bosses, and that's it, you know. And the loot, Salmon, the loot, you never learn, Ammon. Rare sandals on a tendril? Really? Damn it, Ammon, come on, man. This is a new franchise, a new beginning for you. Like, come on, don't let this die as well, Ammon. I believe in you, we all believe in you. If you needed more time, Ammon, who cares? Rockstar, you know, delayed Red Dead Redemption 2 for a year and a half, supposedly. That's what I read online. And look where it is now, it's amazing, it's an incredible game. You know, when you first posted on Reddit saying, guys, I want to release it by April, or was it June, but I don't want you because it's too incomplete. What did we all say? We say, take your time, Ammon. But of course, you know, when you needed more time, when it was due to, you know, release in September, you got scared and said, nah, I'm just going to release it. But honestly, if I were you, Ammon, it would have been better to just held on and just implemented the outpost attacks, you know, other better side missions, the scrubland PvP, the clan, the dust shops, you know. But if you would have released all that in the same package on a different release date, Ammon, you wouldn't be where you would be today, you know. You'll be having an incredible community because there'd be so many things to do. You don't want to grind no more? Let's go PvP. You don't want to, you know, loot anymore? Let's go boss hunting. You know, it just disappoints me as a veteran because, you know, you never really did learn from your mistakes back in the day, you know. When 3D first came out, it was almost identical as Death Frontier 2. You know, no interiors, more or less the same boss, which is the Titan. I mean, and it wouldn't run good on many computers, which, I mean, is the same for Death Frontier 2. Yeah, guys, I mean, like I said, I'm also being neutral. I'm trying to keep it, you know, on the peaceful side because, again, the game is not fully complete, which kind of hurts me because Ammon could do so much with this game. And what also hurts me is that he's one guy as well. You know, he's one guy. Why he never decided to let go of the past and hire other people, I don't know. I mean, if you want to succeed, you gotta let other people help you, you know. You gotta let them help you develop the game. You doing it by yourself is taking too goddamn long, and as you can see, the consequences already started. And the biggest issue that people have right now is, you know, it's too repetitive. You know, there's not much content to do in it, Ammon. There's nothing to explore. It's just mission. Here it is. Here's the buildings. Get inside. Oh my god, more rooms. Oh, let me go into this door. Oh my god, more rooms. Okay, let me go to that door. More rooms. Oh my god, I found the loot. Okay, let's get out of here. Next building. That's it. And if you want a boss hunt, you already know where they are. It's not random. It doesn't catch you off guard, you know? Like, it's just sad, man. I mean, and honestly, yeah, I mean, take it or leave it. It's just my two cents. I feel like you should just hold off a bit and focus on what the community wants. Don't do what you want, because, I mean, look what happened to Call of Duty. You know, people were sick and tired of the freaking futuristic thing that when, you know, when that eventually the community got what they want. Eventually, I mean, your players are the people that are going to feed you, all right? You can be like, yeah, it's my game. I can do whatever I want. At the end of the day, the consumer will always win, you know? It's the same thing for everything we do. I'm making a video and people want to watch more Death Frontier. Well, guess what? I'm going to be like, no, because I quit that. But no, for real. All right. All jokes aside, you know, you go out to a restaurant, you tell the server, hey, I want a water. What are you going to be? What is the server going to say? No, don't worry, sir. I'll get you a water right now. You know? So yeah, I mean, that's just my two cents. Take what you want and take and say what you will. But it's just my two cents as what's going on right now, you know? The game isn't too bad, but it's not too great. out of 10 people that joined your game, probably 2 or 3 will stay, alright? Because, I mean, if you haven't seen the market right now, there are way too many good games out right now that people will not even waste 30 minutes on your game as of now, alright? And I'm just speaking facts at my pawn, alright? So again, this is coming from someone who's been playing your game for 10, 9 years, alright? Take it or leave it. Alright guys, that's all I gotta say. If you guys, you know, got mad at what I gotta say, it's okay. You know, it's just my 2 cents. I'm just a nobody. I'm just a small YouTuber who's trying to make it up, you know, up there with the big boys. But I just want to say what I feel about the Dead Frontier franchise, because I hate seeing it die in such a stupid way, you know. Again, Admin, listen to your audience. They're your people, you know. They're the people that are always going to support you. And if they feel like, you know, they have something to say, don't block them out. Don't feel too disappointed. People have always judged my videos. And guess what? I listen sometimes. I'm like, you know what? He's right. The audio does need to get fixed. He's right. There's way too much lag. He's right. This should be better. You know, I always try to take constructive criticism. Don't ever, ever take criticism, you know, in a bad way. All right. That's the only way we're ever going to grow as humans, honestly, or as people. Taking criticism. It rather is a good thing or a bad thing, you know. But yeah, this is JC Gaming signing out, guys. And I'm basically working on other videos right now. Red Dead Online, Black Ops, etc. So yeah, guys, this is JC Gaming signing out. Peace. I don't wanna be alone.